Hey guys, welcome home to our family room. Our next project that we wanted to share with you guys, I think in the kitchen video, you saw this beautiful piece of art table that we found that we have as a stand-up cocktail table. And I want to talk you through what we did and what our decorating ideas were for this room. So as you see, and you probably saw in some still shots, one of the factors of picking this floor plan was this two-story family room. I really call it a great room. We did this beautiful chandelier, and I'll kind of zoom in, talk to you about that. It is made out of brass. And I think a little elements of gold are in it as well. It was a terrific find that we found inside the city of Atlanta. Can't give away all the secrets, right? And it actually took, I think it was like 8 full hours for our chandelier installer, also an interior designer here in Atlanta, to install this, taking it down from the store, taking off each individual, as you can see as I zoom in, each individual brass ring was quite a task. So we thank Sean, who actually climbed up into our attic to give the support that it needed. And everybody that's come in so far, we've had a lot of contractors in here. Not too many people, obviously some family members that have come and seen it. We haven't had been able to have like a housewarming or anything like that yet because of COVID, but we hope to in the new year, but it gives us time to do projects like this. So obviously the big wall of windows is the big wow factor with the chandelier. As I go a little bit closer, you could see the furniture. Now the furniture was something, you know, we looked weeks and weeks and weeks in advance to, you know, find the right piece. We're at a stage in our life where we've owned, you know, myself multiple homes, and Kurt and I had a previous new home as well. And when you have a room like this, you really can't go basic. So we really, really was looking for something unique, and it's almost like a plaid kind of corduroy, not plaid, but more corduroy material on the actual fabric, and then it's lined in like black and gold along the legs, as you'll see, and along the edges. And we really liked the thought of either two couches or two chairs and a couch, and we decided on this, and I think it came out really, really nice. We also put down the area rug, you know, just, you know, nothing fancy there, shopped around. You know, you have to know where to spend your money and what to offset it with if you're gonna go high end with furniture. So I'll zoom in a little bit more. We wanted to offset it with something simple when you looked from this angle, and this was the bench. Very nice, simple. A little different color, like a little baby blue, hints of gray in it, with the same stainless steel look on the legs. And we got an amazing deal. You would not believe, when you're shopping for furniture, guys, you will not believe the price of cocktail tables. I mean, we looked and we could have spent thousands and thousands of dollars. But it works for this room. It complements the theme that we were going with, which was the brass gold look. And this table is a very, very high-end table. And we found it at a great shop here in Atlanta that gets furniture from all over the world. And I'll zoom in so you can see a little bit. The detail, it has glass, tempered glass on top, but it also has a antique mirror underneath, which complements, again, the above dramatic chandelier. I'll give you a view from this angle as well. As you could see, the two-story family room windows. Now, the next project I want to talk about, we didn't want to unveil it until we had it done properly. This was empty space. This was completely empty space on both sides of the fireplace. We were not happy, you know, with just the standard built-ins that the builder gave. We've had that in other houses and stuff like that. And we just kind of had a vision. We looked for months and months and months through images on Pinterest. We did not hire an interior designer for any of this. This was, a lot of legwork, a lot of going around, a lot of looking online. And we found an amazing carpenter that you probably saw. We'll do another video on Kurt's home office after his desk is done. You saw the built-ins, the picture, and we'll do a video of that as well. But let's walk and see the detail. Now, again, this was all empty space. We have the Carrara marble around the fireplace. And just today, we wanted the right pieces to put on the built-ins. And we found it today. Just driving around, we went through North Druid Hills, we went to Midtown, we went to Buckhead, and this just totally stood out to us. Now, the actual built-ins themselves, totally, I have to give myself credit on that one. It was an image that I kind of created through multiple images that I saw online. And we have Michael, who is an amazing, amazing contractor who we will be using for years to come, probably on our basement. And we have so many projects for him. And for Jay, who's our painter, and the combination of both of them, Michael built this from scratch on both sides. As you see, we picked out the hardware and had him install it, and then Jay did the painting of the gray. And the name slips my mind, but it's a Sherwin-Williams paint. We used a semi-gloss to give it a little bit of a shine. And I think this piece of art that we stumbled upon today is going to give us a lot of options. Right now it works perfect for the fall time with the rocks that were included at the base, but you'll be able to change that out for different seasons. In the holidays, you could do those colorful bulbs and decorative balls and stuff like that. And then we offset it with the gold brass handles as well. And I just want to show you some of the details of the wood that was used. Now, this was really quality wood, not something you would find, and no offense to like an IKEA or anything like that. We've all done that. But look at the details of the bench. I mean, of the sliding soft closed doors and the cabinet doors. So it really, I think, came out fantastic. And we did the kind of squared trim in the middle, as you can see, with the connecting lines on each side. So it all kind of came together. We also, at the time of building the house, we said we had pictures of, in our mind, of we wanted to do statues or some kind of built-in. So we added these recessed lighting on each side as well. And then finally, just giving you a view from this angle, again, showing you the catwalk, which was something that was really eye-catching when we looked at this floor plan. And we added additional lighting at the top too. So you have them all on dimmers now. So it really sets the stage and the mood for the house. And I think we did, really, really well. I'd love to hear your feedback. It's been really exciting building this house together and decorating it. And I think it's really touched into the creativity of the both of us. And that's one of the, wonderful things about home ownership is compared to an apartment, you typically don't take a lot of pride in an apartment, right? Because it's not yours, it's a landlord's. So to be able to put your own touch on it, to see the pride, and in this time of kind of social distancing and self-quarantine when you can, it's just a really, really enjoyable process that we've taken on as a family and, you know, taken on a lot of pride as well. And finally, you can see the mirror that we actually brought from our last house. And I think it just complements and goes with the themes of the mirrors and the wall of windows. So we don't have much more to do. We have some other ideas down the line that we might add to the room. But for now, I think it's come out excellent. And just wanted to share with you guys. Again, our whole mission is to inspire you to reach for your dreams. And invest in yourself and invest in your home, because it is an investment and just something to take great pride in. All right, guys, make it a great day, and we look forward to hearing from you soon.